It's Monday morning, and what better way to start a Monday than taking a look at an international device? Up today, the Sony Xperia Z Ultra. I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com. Let's take a look at Sony's phablet device that's going up against the Galaxy Note 2 and the LG Optimus G Pro. Here it is, the Sony Xperia Z Ultra, a 6.44-inch display device, and this thing is packed to the gills with great specifications. Now, at least right now, you can't get this on a carrier in the U.S., but you can get it unlocked through an awesome specialty retailer. That retailer is Negri Electronics, and you can get this at NegriElectronics.com. The link is right here below in the video. I want to give special thanks to them. They got this device over to us for review purposes, for taking a look at it. So special thanks to Negri Electronics. And also, before I unbox it, special thanks to my partners at Best Buy Mobile. They give us devices like these and others, HTC Ones, iPhone 5s, for use in our One Pod Bandit giveaway game. When you walk into Best Buy Mobile, you'll deal with unbiased advice, whether you need Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, whatever you need, they'll make sure you walk out with what's best for you at Best Buy Mobile. So the Xperia Z Ultra, quick spec rundown here on this device. You've got an 8-megapixel camera. Actually, no, let's start all the way up at the beginning, because really the processor is one of the awesome things about this unit. It's a 2.2 gigahertz quad-core Snapdragon 800 CPU, so not 600, this is an 800 CPU device. You've got Android 4.2 Jelly Bean here with Sony's UI. You got an 8-megapixel camera with 1080p HD recording, a 6.44-inch 1080 by 1920 pixels display, so 344 PPI here. Huge display, bigger than the Note 2, bigger than the Optimus G Pro, really pushing, actually bigger than the Samsung Galaxy Mega as well, so really pushing that line between tablet device or tablet smartphone and just overall tablet. I mean, this thing's going to be a huge device. So you're probably thinking, open it up and let's take a look, which is exactly what I'm going to do. Here is the Sony Xperia Ultra, and while we're talking about it, I will continue to run through the specifications. 3,050 milliamp hour battery here. It is a non-removable battery, and overall the design language here, very similar to the Sony Xperia Z, or Z, depending on how you say it. If you're Canadian, you may say Z, or perhaps British. Sony startup guide. Let's see what comes out of the box here. So our startup guide, something I can't read. Also something I can't read. Sorry information. Not that I read these anyway, so I'm not gonna take the time to read them. But earbud stuff here. Got a nice little pair of earbuds that come with the device. And then you got an adapter. Looks like a British adapter there, but you can get, of course, an American adapter, which actually Negri Electronics ships in the box. So if you're not in the UK, sorry, I had an issue getting this box closed. If you're not in the UK, you can get an American adapter and you'll get it for free in the box with Negri Electronics, or you can just pick up one of your current micro USB chargers and just use it. It's really not that hard. That is, usually I'm much better at reboxing than this, but you know what? That's okay. It's Monday morning. I'm gonna cut myself some slack and we're gonna power this sucker on. But before we do that, we'll take a look. Very, very thin device here. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack over on the side. Micro SD card slot right here with your micro SIM card slot. Power button, volume rocker. Again, design language very similar to the Sony Xperia Z. Nothing down here at the bottom but a speaker. And then you've got, it looks like nothing over here, just an area for a dock. I'm assuming you can plug it down into a dock and use this like a multimedia unit. But here it is, and we'll power it up. And it is a big device. Let's find some other devices to compare it to. Let's see what we've got here. I'm gonna let that power up, and I'm going to reach behind me in my drawers. Not in my pants. Not my pants, in my drawers, my office drawers. As you can see right here, HTC Ones beside it. So to give you an idea of comparison, size-wise, boom, that is exactly the size. So it's a big phone. It's hard to hold in the hand. And there it is right there, but a gorgeous 6.44-inch display. Say that three times fast, 6.44 inches. Again, it is 1080 by 1920, so a full 1080p HD display here, 344 PPI, really a nice unit, and you've got Android 4.2 running out of the box. Now you've got Sony's user interface, no longer called Timescape, but just Sony's UI, and out of the box, typical stuff here. Let me move this so the lights don't reflect off of it. You've got Google stuff, you've got Sony's Walkman album, movies, Sony Select, you've got Social Life, and of course Facebook integration, Smart Connect, all the stuff that we saw and talked about with the Xperia Z, both the international version and the T-Mobile version. So Android 4.2, I'll press and hold home, I can have easy access to Google Now. I've got my recent applications right here, and this is a nice little trick from the Xperia Z. I've got these quick applications as well, which I can move around. Go ahead and move that around and use that if I want to. I can go down here, and I can add more if I want to as well. I can do bookmarks, for example, I can bring that down here. I can do Gmail if I want to. We'll bring it down, and then I'll go back over here and click on it. And I don't have a Google account set up right now, so obviously that's not going to work. But let's see, calculator, for example, move it around, do my calculations, but I can still use the device. So it's really a nice angle on multitasking. And you can, of course, do your calculations and more. So overall, the look and feel of this device, very similar to the Xperia Z. No real differences so far that I can tell, but again, I'm fresh on this device as well. I've got some other stuff here. Backup and restore Neo Reader. Forgive me, I don't know if that's Taiwanese or Japanese or Chinese, but you can take a look right there. Startup. It's Brazil. Actually, why is that? I'm saying FIFA World Cup Brazil. Never mind, that is not Brazilian. Duh, Aaron. Clearly, it is a Monday. AA Stocks, Sony Update Center as well, and then I've got File Commander. So a lot of different Sony installed applications, and I don't have it connected to the web just yet, but I want to show you kind of what the browser looks like here. No thanks. So you can see just how big that display actually is. And we'll go ahead and connect it to the web. So now we're all connected via Wi-Fi, and you can see phonedog.com loaded up here. Again, 6.44-inch display. Portrait landscape really fast thanks to that huge Snapdragon 800 CPU. Very, very fast with the quad-core processor. And you can see phonedog.com. Now, keyboard, not really any different than what you can see. Obviously, there's Chinese input here as well. But I can type in, you know, CNN, for example. Go to .com, you can see the keyboard, very similar, again, I keep saying this, but to what we've seen on other Xperia devices. But really nice to have this big display for content creation, so whether you're browsing the web, perhaps you're watching YouTube as well. Let me go find YouTube here and say YouTube, and let's do an existing account. And whoops, Heron Baker. And forgive me, I'm going to type in my password. I love cookies. Okay, that is actually not my password, but it sounded pretty good. And I do love cookies, so admittedly, it could very well be my password. But you can see YouTube right here. Again, really taking advantage of that big display. Phone dog. There we go. Boom. And we'll take a look at iOS 7. This is like blasphemy, taking a look at an iOS 7 video, but I just want to show you what it looks like on this big old display. Really nice, and again, I'm gonna put this down here so you can see what the size difference looks like. And skip that ad. And loading, 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 loading. I'll lay it down so you can see the screen size difference here.
Seven has historically been a lucky number, and Apple is
really a big display and great again for content creation like this. Keep it locked on phonedog.com for more on the Sony Xperia Z, or excuse me, Xperia Ultra. I keep saying Xperia Z so many times that I'm going to pick up Xperia Z and start calling it Xperia Z. I also wanted to point out this. Here is your micro USB charging port. I'm on Twitter at phonedog_Aaron, Facebook, facebook.com/HiAaronBaker, Google+, g+.to/phonedog. Let me know what you think of Sony's phablet or tablet phone, whatever you want to call it, the Sony Xperia Ultra. We'll have full coverage in the coming days on phonedog.com. In the meantime, hit me up on Twitter with your questions, and they may be answered in the review. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.